So, can G29 Racing Wheel compete with Direct Drive FANATEC Racing Wheel on Formula One 2019? Well, let's find out. Let's find out to see if a $400 racing wheel can compete to a something that's $800 or $900 or $1,000 Direct Drive FANATEC. Now, FANATEC, I understand. It's a more professional, authentic racing wheel. I get that. I understand it. I know why it's expensive. But what about for those of you who are not willing to go all the way FANATEC and spend that kind of FANATEC money? How about the Logitech G29? Well, let's find out, shall we? Let's do it.
the session so far.
How about that, huh? How about that, Fanatec? Mr. Hamilton 4K, how about that?
drops of fuel remaining. Thank you.
I'm not going to pit because this is my last lap. So there's no point of me pitting. What's the point? And I don't want to lose my place. I'm at 12. I have to pit. Hell with it. Well, anyway, the whole point of this video was just to show you that you don't necessarily need to have FANATEC Racing Wheel Direct Drive to be that accurate and that successful in the races. You saw what I was able to do with this racing wheel. I was at the top 10, top 12. My fastest lap was even faster than Lewis Hamilton. On the fourth lap, I had the fastest lap, and Lewis Hamilton was the second. So this shows you what I was able to do with this racing wheel. Okay, so hopefully this gives you some idea as to that maybe you don't necessarily need to have a FANATEC direct drive to accomplish what you need to accomplish. You'll be just fine with this racing wheel G29. Maybe it's not the racing wheel. Maybe it's you. How good are you driving it? You know, you can have the best racing wheel in the world, but it depends on how good of a driver you are. I think that's the key thing that people are missing out here. Thank you. Uh-oh, that shouldn't have happened.
Line that front wing. It'll need replacing if it takes too much damage.
And I'm not even a professional race driver, and look what I can achieve with this racing wheel G29. This gotta be the longest practice I have ever done, in all honesty. We almost there, guys. We got maybe 1 minute and a half left to practice too, and it's over. Like I said, my whole point here was just to show you that you don't necessarily need to have a FANATEC racing wheel in order for you to be competitive in Formula One 2019 or iRacing. Now, don't get me wrong. Having that direct drive, having that FANATEC, sure, it's going to help, but it, you know. At the end of the day, it's not what kind of racing wheel you have, it's just how good of a driver are you. How experienced are you driving? I think that's the key thing. And that's what I was trying to show you here. Here I am with this toy. People call it toy, even though it's $400-something. It's called Logitech G29.
Just 30 seconds left in the session.
I did put some good pointers here. I had my best lap and everything, so I'm happy with this. It's fine. I did run out of fuel, so I had to, you know, get the fuel and all that. But overall, you can see exactly how good this racing wheel is with Formula One 2019. If you're thinking about buying this racing wheel, well, there you go.
You've got front wing damage. Recommend you box for a new one.
Alright, so this is it, finally. I usually don't like these practices because they're so goddamn long. I usually just go for a qualify.
To remind ourselves of our top three, who are
Hamilton, Hülkenberg, and Carlos Sainz.
What an incredible practice session. The fun doesn't stop.
All right, well, there you have it, guys. I hope this video gives you some idea as to, you know, how good this racing wheel is. You know, this is a practice, so I really don't care about the practice that much. It's impossible for you to make it to the top 10 on the practice, because it's some kind of an AI problem here. I think they made this game so difficult on the practice that you can really never compete with the Hamilton and all the other guys. But you saw just how well I'm able to race with this racing wheel. You saw how well, forget the Formula One, it doesn't have to be Formula One, it could be any game. And it just shows you how accurate this racing wheel is. Well, there you go. I hope you guys enjoy this. I know it's a bit of a long video, but that's the whole point, just to show you how good this racing wheel is. So do you really need a Fanatec? Now, if you can't afford a Fanatec, go with a Fanatec, obviously, direct drive. But if you can't, this will get the job done, in my opinion. All right, guys, have a good one.